Good morning, students. Today we will see another safety device which can also be used in place of electric fuse. In fact, nowadays this only safety device has been is brought into use. The reason is that because it switch off the circuit, it breaks the circuit in a very short time. Around in 25 milliseconds it breaks the circuit, and the name of this device is miniature circuit breakers. So we have another safety device called miniature circuit breakers. In short, we say MCB. So we can say this device as an automatic switch which will break the circuit automatically whenever there is an excess amount of current flowing through the circuit. Actually, due to this heavy current, the switch will fall down and it can be reset once again by raising the switch up. So we cannot have the difficulty of changing the wire again and again like in the case of electric fuse. So this can be very useful because of its breaking the circuit power is in a very short duration it can break, and we can use it in all the electrical appliances. We can have next about household electric circuit. Household electric circuit. The circuit that we find in our houses, they are parallel connections. Means the appliances used, the resistance used, they all are connected in parallel. Something this way we find the parallel connection taking place. Parallel connection or parallel combination. Where we find all the resistances used in a given circuit is parallel. This suppose we have three resistance R1, R2 and R3, and all these resistance are parallel to each other, and it is connected to a source of current where current can be generated and is supplied to each of these resistances. Now the advantage of connecting the appliances in parallel is that equal voltage is given to all the resistances, to all the appliances, and we can also use these appliances individually. If suppose due to any reason, if one appliance does not work, then it will make the other appliances to work without any disturbance. And the very important thing is that we can make as many connections possible in parallel as we need. So parallel connection is the connection that is done in the houses instead of the series connection. I'll show you the series connection, how it is done. In series combination, all the resistances, the three resistances will be connected in series. This is how. And then it is connected to the source of the current. Now here you can see that if one, due to any reason, if there is no current flowing through one resistance, the other appliances also get disturbed they will also stop working. You might have seen the twinkling bulb that we use in Diwali, where one bulb blows off, then it completely blows off the other box also. It means to say that other box also stop working. That is due to the series connection. In parallel connection, we don't find such problem taking place. If there is fault in one appliance, due to this, if the current does not go to that appliance, it will not affect the other appliances. Let us come to power rating of the appliance. Power rating of appliance. You might have seen the ratings mentioned on the appliances. These ratings can be the power and also the voltage, that at what voltage will this appliance work. So these two ratings are generally mentioned in the appliances. For example, if you have a bulb whose rating given is 100 watt and 220 volts. Now from these ratings, we can find the resistance of the appliance and also we can find the safe limit of the current. That means what will be the safe limit of the current so that this appliance will work without getting damaged. So let us see how can we find out. From this it is clear that this 100 watt is power of the appliance and this is the voltage given. It means to say that if this appliance of power 100 watt is given 200 volts or 220 volts, then it will consume energy at the rate of 100 joule per second. So from this power and this voltage, we can also find out what amount of electrical energy is used per second. Let us see what different things we can find. We can find the safe limit of current. Safe limit of current. That is, for this appliance, we can find using this formula P by P, which is equal to 100 divided by 220 volts. That is around 0.5 ampere will be the safe limit of this current. It means to say that if the current exceeds 0.5 ampere, the appliance has every chance to get damaged due to this heavy current. We can also calculate the resistance of this appliance using this formula, because we know P equal to V is equal to V square by R, so R can be equal to V square by V, and V square is 220 into 220 divided by power is 100. That is, we have got the resistance of this appliance equal to 484 ohm. So this is how we can calculate the safe limit of the current by the rating mentioned in the appliance, and also we can find the resistance of the appliances. So next class we will discuss about the hazards of electricity, and we can also see what precautions should one take in order to get prevented from any kind of electrical mishap. So these all precautions are very important, because we require utmost care while handling these electrical appliances, otherwise it can be very fatal also. So next class we will discuss more about this.